In my dreams, I heard your footsteps coming closer. In my dreams, I tried to talk to you and introduce myself. Guardian of the miracle and of the miracle banner, with great pain, I carry the emblem of the Father. I am the hands of bloodied skin. I am the eyes from which your mother gazes. But nothing I know of you, apart from your cold, nameless visage, apart from your calloused and wounded hands, apart from the mourning of your deaths. No, I know nothing of you. Only the miracle knows. Now may your sword, full of guilt, with mine of gold, collide. Let them hurt and march in procession. I curse you forever in name. I bless you forever in death. Now you see me awoken as the son of the true miracle.
You have freed His Holiness from his afflicted torment. And now he walks by the old processions on the other side of the dream. The cradle of the grievous miracle, the final relic. The grail of blood and gold that emanated from the forehead of the Father as he silently lamented the moment of his blessed twisting. That first relic is here, at the top of the Ashen Mountain, next to the Turn Throne, where His Holiness was kissed by a miraculous pain. And now, your final communion with the miracle awaits. Only you will be able to know how much of it has seeped into your guilty heart. Thus came the moment of final communion with the Swordborn of Guilt. A last sacrifice in order to finish penance and break off with the ungodly will of the grievous miracle. But the plans of the miracle are capricious. Penance never ends, but changes. Hurts and condemns at will. There is no place for the penitent one on the other side of the dream. His place is here among us. He is the new father and the last son of the miracle. Recipient of our prayers forever and ever.
And thus shall your name be erased under the heavens.